Who is the mother of the snow? I mean, he asked him 186 questions. And when God got through with it, Job said, "Lord, I can't answer none of these. I plead the fifth." And then Job, what? He realized, amen, that God is a what? God of all. And God is a God that what? He knows everything, and nobody can what? Add nothing to God, right? Then Job humbled himself and said, "Lord, I abhor myself. I hate myself. I ain't about nothing. I am stupid. I need help."
Yes, Lord.
And the Bible told Job, hallelujah, to offer up a ransom. Amen. That means he had to offer up a sacrifice, and then I want you to pray for your friends. Because he was mad at his friends because they were accusing him of what? Being us, amen, unfaithful to God. And when he prayed for his friends, the Bible says God turned the what? Captivity of Job. Amen. Amen. So Job didn't stay slick. When Job got in line with God's word and placed himself in a position for God to what? Change his circumstances, then, amen, God came right in the door with his mercy, with his love, with his mercy. You know, somebody said, "Goodness and mercy shall what? Follow me."
Hallelujah. Yeah.
As only if you place yourself in a position where goodness and mercy what can follow you. See, there's a man with side and a God with side to every battle, to every victory. How many can say amen? There's something that God has already done. See, God has already done what he's going to do. Is that right? Amen. You got to what? Do your part. You got to play your role. Amen. How many can say amen? There's something you got to do. Amen. And I believe a whole lot of getting in position for God to bless you, I believe a lot of it is in, praise God, lining up with what? The word of God. How many can say amen? Amen. God delighteth in what? Mercy. He gives what? Grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from them that what? Walk uprightly before him. If God healed Job and he restored back to him all that he had lost, amen, how many times? Double. Amen. 10 children. He turned around. Amen. The calamity, the storm wiped all of his kids out at one time. All of them went down in that what whirlwind. But when God turned his captivity, God restored. Amen. Not only gave him 10, but what? 20. And the Bible says he was the richest man of the East. Amen. He might not just have maybe 10 million. But when God turned his captivity, he had 20. Hey, hallelujah. When God got through with Job, amen, Job lived many years after, amen, praise God, his calamity, and he was able to see his children, children's children, and children, amen, the many generations. Amen. How many here say amen?
Amen?
Amen. Now I just want to turn to the scripture. I'm just about through. Turn to James 5. Amen. This is a good scripture. I want you to, hallelujah. James 5, 11. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Hey, yes, yes. Yes. James 5, I want you to turn to that scripture. I want you to look at the 11th verse. It says, "Behold, we count them happy which endure." Speaking about Job. "Ye have heard of the patience of Job, and have seen the end of the Lord, that the Lord is very pitiful and of tender mercy." That's the message that we want, amen, to convey. That the Lord is very pitiful. In other words, he's touched with whatever you're going through.
Yeah.
Now, what a difference it would make when you met people, when you began to minister to them, when you began to build relationships with them, for you to convey messages that reflect God's compassion. Amen. That will open people up like nothing else. It's more effective than telling people that they're going to hell. Amen. See, God's goodness is designed to lead people to what? Repentance. How many can say amen? Amen. See, we know that sometimes the sentence against the evil is not easy, is not what? Executed speedily. See, sometimes people can't rightly divide, amen, God's goodness. How can God be so good to people that persist in what? Sin for so long. And sometimes people will misconstrue God's goodness and God's love and God's compassion to mean that what? Well, I'm okay. I don't have to repent. I don't have to turn around. I can just go, keep on going the direction I'm going. Amen. And they don't realize that it's God's goodness that's trying to get their attention before they fall off the cliff. Amen. God's sentence against evil is not going to be always what it carried out speedily. But God will what? Keep on blessing. He'll keep on what? Bless. He'll keep on, amen, hallelujah, releasing his mercy. He'll keep on, amen, being full of compassion. Amen. What the scripture says, Sister Denise had me with this other night. He said that he that is often reproved and hardened his neck shall suddenly. How many know that God is full of mercy, full of love? Amen. But sometimes the cup of wrath gets full to the brim. Amen. Hallelujah. It's not going to be executed speedily. But sometimes, amen, that cup of wrath, amen, that God is going to pour out is what? Begins to what? Build. A little bit more. When it gets about one third full, most of the time he doesn't do anything. And people say, well, that's a pretty good deal. I can do anything I want and nothing is happening, man. I like this already. I like how God is. God is good. Just keep on doing it. God is good. See, no sentence against evil can even execute it. That cup of wrath keeps what? Building.
Yes.
Keeps on building. But the scripture says in Romans 2, do you despise the goodness of the Lord, not knowing that it's the goodness of the Lord that leads you to repentance? Do you despise that? Do you overlook? Amen. Do you misconstrue God's goodness that God is going to put up with whatever thing in your life that's preventing you from receiving, amen, that grace that God has for you? See, it's a sin to, amen, close the door and to, amen, praise God, make it impossible for God to get his grace to you. That's resisting the what? Amen, the power of God that's coming against God. Hallelujah! But one day, if you just keep on ignoring the goodness of the Lord, then the hatchet is going to fall. And when the cup gets full, amen, then God said, amen, time is up. I've given you 50 years. I've given you 10. I've given you 5 years. Amen. Goodness and mercy will still what? Tracking you down. Amen. But one day, Sister Denise said, amen, praise God, that, amen, praise God. It says that when amen, praise, how does that go? He that is often reproved and hard his neck shall what? Suddenly. See, judgment is a strange word for God. It's not, it doesn't describe God's primary desire or will for you. God mainly is a God of love. How many understand that? And that's what he wants to what? To release. He wants goodness and mercy following us. And judgment is something that God, amen, he hates to do. He'll give you what? Opportunity after opportunity after opportunity after opportunity. after opportunity. But one day, amen, praise God, God is going to what? Amen. We're going to go beyond, you know, that's a point of no return. How many going to, amen? Amen. So this is the scripture that we were just saying here. Behold, we count them happy which endure. You have heard of the patience of Job and have seen the end of the Lord, that the Lord is very pitiful and of what? Tender mercy. In other words, when Job repented and got things right, amen, God turned his captivity and he was able to what? Restore back to Job all of the things that were what? That were taken from him. Amen. How many of you say amen? Amen. Now, verse 13 applies to you here. Is any among you afflicted? How many got aches and pains?
Amen.
How many going through stuff?
Amen.
How many not content with your life? How many got some financial afflictions? Y'all look at me. I'm all right. I'm all right. Amen. Some just barely scraping by. Some of y'all got some financials. Text somebody and say, you got any financial afflictions? Amen. Some of y'all worry now. You ain't at peace. You ain't at ease because what? You got bills you can't pay. Amen. Praise God. You barely got enough gas to get back home. Is any afflicted among you? So it's good to know how it happened, amen, for Job, what Job had to do. But it's good to know what God wants you to do, amen, to turn your captivity. How many of you are in captivity?
Yeah.
Y'all know what captivity is. When you ain't got no money, you're in captivity. When you're all broken down, God don't want you broken down in middle age or in your senior years. He don't want you what? Crippled and hopping and just barely making it. Amen. He wants you what? Full of health and vitality. Is any afflicted among you?
Yes.
Here's the solution. I got it. I got a good passion. My sister Eva really loves me. I can tell how she smells. Is there an afflicted among you? Amen. I'm going to tell you how to get out from under that affliction.
All right.
I'm going to tell you how to get out from under that handicap.
Yes.
Is any afflicted among you? Here's the answer, Sister Shirley. She's found it out. Let him pray. All right. I'm trying to get y'all free from y'all afflictions and y'all don't have a clue. I'm going to try again in another week or so. I'm going to try to get some of y'all out here early at 5 o'clock. I believe a whole lot of afflictions will go away. All right, I'm not done. Let him pray. I ain't talking about Job now. Well, we know Job prayed for his friends. Amen. You might need to pray for yours too. If you talked about them, if they mad at you, if you ain't done right about them, if you can't get along with them, you might need to pray for your friends. Let him pray. Amen. A whole lot of y'all's answers are in what? You praying.
That's right. Amen.
Is any Mary? Amen. Is any Mary? Anybody marry? I don't see too many married people here today. Happy. Amen. Anybody happy here today? All right. How many happy people do we have here today? All right. His admonition to everybody that's happy, let them sing songs. Why aren't you singing them? Why am I? Y'all looking at me like a calf looking at a new gate. When I began to sing, amen, the Lord God is full of, amen, amen, the Lord God is what? A sun and a shield. I sing that in the morning time. He gives grace and glory. I make a tune out of that. I sing that and I get very happy. And when I get very happy, I make others around me very happy. To me, that's worth coming to a prayer meeting for. Then I'm seeing what Psalms. See, all of these scriptures I'm giving you now are no more than Psalms.
All right, so my time is up. This little red thing goes up and says, Nina. Y'all know my wife. Y'all know my wife. She keeps me on the track. She's good. The Lord is good. Is any sick among you?
Yes.
This is what you're supposed to do. Is anyone sick among you? Let him call for the what? Elders of the church. And let them what? And let, amen, praise him. Let them pray over him.
Glory to God.
It should be a lot easier. Amen. For me to try. Amen. Amen. It would be a lot easier for you to come out here and let me pray over you. Than me to track all y'all down individually to pray over you. Oh, Jesus. Let him pray over. How many of you can be prayed over? You don't believe it. Amen. If you're sick, then, if you're sick, you need to just be in prayer. Amen. The first week or several days, nothing might not happen. But you need to be what? Prayed over.
Yes.
To get rid of some of them doubts.
Yes.
Some of those hindrances.
Yes.
Some of those what? Praise God. Barriers.
Yes.
Some of those dead ways.
Yes.
Let them pray.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. Brother Holman, I believe I got an answer. I'm supposed to be praying over y'all. I can't pray over y'all at home, amen, between y'all sheets. And you said, the Bible says, what, let them pray over them, anointing them with what? Oil in the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And the prayer of faith. Save the sick. And the Lord shall what? Raise them up. All right, praise God. I'm going to call for everybody that have any kind of affliction. Financial affliction. Amen. You might need $500 or $5,000. Amen. You got a spiritual affliction. You got a what? Amen. Spiritual affliction. You got a, amen, physical affliction. Amen. Maybe you don't have no Mary. How many need some Mary? How many need some Mary so you can sing some songs? Somebody needs some Mary in here. All right. Those that's Mary need to what? Sing some. So some of y'all are a long way from Mary because you don't even think you need no Mary. Amen. Praise God. The prayer thing. The prayer of faith. How many can say the prayer of faith? Hey, yeah. The prayer of faith shall what? Save us. The prayer of what? Faith. Somebody say the prayer of
faith.
Shall what? Save us.
Your captivity.
Yes.
If it's financially, it's going to turn your captivity. What I mean by flow in the spirit is ministering the spirit of the Lord in here. It means that you are going to seek to try to get in line. Everything that you are doing is in God's power.
Yeah. you came on our hearts. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Yes, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. We can pray to the Lord. For I thank you. Lord, we sing the end of your mercy. Thank you, Lord. We can pray to the Lord. It shall be according to your way, your will. We give you praise of the Lord. In Jesus' name. Hey!
And how pitiful he was to Job in the end of his circumstance. Amen. If you want that, first come, first serve. Probably just got a feel. Amen. But if you would like to have that book to meditate on this week and to help build you up further, amen, you need to, amen, release $5 for the purchase of that book today. Amen. Let's all stand. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Hey. Turn around and tell the person the Lord is gracious. Full of compassion. The Lord is gracious. Full of compassion. Slow to anger in our great mercy. Oh, thank you. Lord, we thank you today. And the goodness and mercy will continue to follow us all the days of our lives. And we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can think of us. According to the power that worketh in us. To the only wise God, be glory, honor, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Everybody say, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.